Hey everybody, Johnny Laser here, and today we're going to try something a little different. So, I like eating hamburgers, and you put the relish on. I always save the jars after they're empty. And what I like to do is, I like to save the jars and then etch them for certain ideas. For example, for my brushes. This is brushes for painting. Over here, I have Q-tips for cleaning. Little picture of Rosie the Robot from the Jetsons on here. Kind of interesting. But today I want to try something a little different. I want to take this jar and I want to recreate Duff beer. But I want to recreate it a little different. I want to have a frosted white background and also engraved with black, the lettering. So a two-stage engraving on one jar. Let's see if we can do that. Hopefully it works out. Maybe it won't. Who knows? That's what all these videos are about. All right. What we're going to need is we're going to need the rotary tool, some painter's tape, white chalk paint, some titanium dioxide, and some black chalk paint. All right. So with the titanium dioxide, we're going to mix that into the white paint and we're going to thin it out just a little bit so we can brush it on. All right. And then the black chalk paint we'll brush on afterwards. Let's do that right now. So over here, I'm going to use this little container to mix all my stuff in. I'm going to take my titanium dioxide, open it up. I'm going to use a teaspoon. Just take a little bit, not too much, maybe half a teaspoon. I'm going to mix it into the little jar here. Close it up. I'm going to take my white chalk paint here. And I'm going to pour a little bit into the white cup here. Alrighty. Close that up. Now I'm just going to add a little bit of water. Thin it out a bit. Oh, I'm gonna grab something else. Grab myself a little mini popsicle stick and mix this up a bit. Okay. And I'm just gonna wrap that up in there and that's gonna be tossed out. All right. Now, let's get our brush, our painter's tape, and a pencil. We took our painter's tape and we put the painter's tape right on the glass here, and we take a pencil and we mark a little X on there, a little plus sign, I guess. This is for picking up when we switch from the white paint to the black paint. All right, so now let's apply a little coat of white paint on here with the titanium dioxide. Got my brush. And just nicely, nice even strokes. And there we have a nice even stroke, or nice even paint job. White paint with the titanium dioxide on our jar. Now we're going to let that dry, and then we're going to put it under laser tool and see what it looks like coming out. Hopefully we make it black. All right? So let's let it dry, and then we'll get back to the laser tool. So now we're back. The paint has dried, and we're going to set it up in the rotary tool, and we're going to cut the first outline in black, okay? Let's do that now. All right. Now, when tightening it up, I got it snug. I put my little chuck key into the hole here. Give it a slight tight. And then I turn it to the other hole, and I give that a little bit of tightness as well. And that will help hold it, because these worm gears, they tend to be loose. So you tighten up one, and then you tighten up the other. Now we're going to level it out. Here we go. Nice and level. We use our center finding apparatus here, and that will help us find the center much easier and align everything. Turn it on. I will line up the green laser with my letter X that I have on my paint here. And I can bring this across. And line her up. All right, she's lined up. We will remove this laser, and we'll pick up the top. All right, we got the top. Now, we're going to line up the X with our X on our masking tape here, so that we can pick it up next time. Alrighty. We take a quick measurement from that back. That's roughly 460 thou. So I'll position my print accordingly. There we go. And then we'll frame it in. All right. And now we'll cut it. Engrave it, I should say. Ready? Let's remove it. And as we can see, yeah, could have used maybe a little more titanium dioxide, but it's a blacker color. Now we have to go over here and we have to wash off the white paint and re-dry it, and we have to put black chalk paint, and then we're gonna frost the inside. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna wash off the white paint. Careful not to remove the paint masking tape with your X here, okay? Take that. Okay, now we will go and reapply the black paint on here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take the black paint here and we're going to apply it across here. All right. Now, we have our black paint on, we will let that dry, and then we'll go and laser it. It should frost the center of our black outline. All right, let's let that dry, and then we'll be right back. Okay, the paint is dry. We've picked up center. We're ready to engrave the frosting. And let us begin. Now, if we have done it properly, and everything lined up, we'll have the inside frosted with black on the outside. Now all we have to do is wash the black paint off and wash it all down. We can remove this now and we'll see what we came up with. Alrighty, let us wash it off. See how accurate we were. And there we have two-tone coloring on our glass. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. And there we have our two-tone glass. Black around the outside. All the lettering is black. And frosted in the center. So we can see if we take little piece of paper, roll it up a bit, place it inside. We can see we have black on the outside and frosted in the center. Now again, with everything, it's all about testing. Test, test, test. I came up with this idea just the other, in my sleep actually, and it worked. The only thing I would do different, a little more titanium dioxide in the mix, maybe a second layer of white after it dried, just to make sure it gets a good coating, so it gets a nice thick blackness on it, and a little better on the alignment to line up the frosting with the black. But other than that, she came out pretty good. I'm going to also try doing it in reverse, painting it black first, frost the area, and then do black lettering on top of that. That might work better. I'll let you know. All right. Hey, until next time, keep on testing. Have a lot of fun. Happy lasering. Later. I'm going to go back to the